美国爆发国会骚乱，各界都把罪魁祸首的骂名指向总统特朗普，而这名狂人总统在卸任前夕成为了美国史上第一位遭到两次弹劾的总统。不过参议院却表态不会在特朗普卸任之前举行听证会。
特朗普支持者上星期三冲击国会大楼，大肆破坏，为美国民主史留下黑记录后，为了防止闹剧重演，当局加派人手，大批国民警卫队成员继续驻扎国会大厦，预计未来几天会有至少15000名警卫驻守华盛顿特区，迎接后任总统拜登的就职典礼。议会厅外守卫森严，议会厅内同样气氛严肃，因为众议院正在辩论表决总统弹劾案。民主党籍众议院议长佩洛西谴责特朗普针对总统大选结果不断撒谎，甚至试图动摇其他官员和领袖再次暴动，这样的国家领袖一刻也留不得。
We know that we face enemies of the Constitution. We know we experience the insurrection that violated the sanctity of the people's capital and attempted to overturn the duly recorded will of the American people. And we know that the President of the United States incited this insurrection, this armed rebellion against our common country. He must go. He is a clear and present danger to the nation that we all love.
不过，共和党籍众议院少数党领袖麦卡锡倒认为，发生暴动后迅速弹劾总统是错误的决定，很可能会进一步分裂国家，煽动民怨。但他承认，特朗普也必须负上责任，因此建议设立调查委员会，或许是更合适的方案。
He should have immediately denounced the mob when he saw what was unfolding. These facts require immediate action by President Trump.Accept his share of responsibility, quell the brewing unrest, and ensure President-elect Biden is able to successfully begin his term. And the president's immediate action also deserves congressional action, which is why I think a fact-finding commission and a censure resolution would be prudent. Unfortunately, that is not where we are today.
国会黑人议员连线也把煽动冲击国会的罪名扣在特朗普的头上，同时认为白人至上主义是这场暴动的导火线。特朗普对黑人平权的无作为，加深了少数族群对狂人总统的不满。就算距离特朗普时代落幕只剩下一个星期，也必须将这个分裂国家的领袖拉下台。
St. Louis and I rise in support of the article of impeachment against Donald J. Trump. If we fail to remove a white supremacist president who incited a white supremacist insurrection, it's communities like Missouri's 1st District that suffer the most. The 117th Congress must understand that we have a mandate to legislate in defense of black lives. The first step in that process is to root out white supremacy, starting with impeaching the white supremacist in chief.
This action will only serve to further affect.And the 75 million people who voted for President Trump and further deepen the division within our nation as we try to move forward with a peaceful transition of power. However, the Democrat majority has determined he's already guilty and there's no need of a trial, and they therefore move forward quickly with this phony impeachment charge. Today, I join my Republican colleagues in standing against this further effort to divide our nation.
经过朝野唇枪舌战后，弹劾议案终于进入表决阶段。在10名共和党议员倒戈后，众议院最终以232张赞成票和197张反对票，第二次通过弹劾，让特朗普成为美国史上第一位遭遇两次弹劾的在位总统。佩洛西签署弹劾议案前一再强调，没有任何人可以凌驾法律，就算是高高在上的总统也不例外。众议院将履行誓言，捍卫美国宪法。众议院火速通过弹劾议案，下一关就来到了参议院。不过，距离总统卸任只剩一个星期，参议院多数党领袖麦康奈尔就发文告，表明时间过于仓促，无法在总统下台前进行公平严肃的听证会，意味着特朗普应该能够顺利坐满任期，随后才面对国会审判。